What's the paragraph?
Seven.
Okay. While her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia to the summit of Vibhan Stanis has touched the hearts of tennis fans, for the younger herself, there appears to be no room for sentiment. So while her journey from the frozen pearls of Siberia to the summit of women's tennis, so she started from Siberia, reached in America, US, Florida. There she reached the pinnacle of glory. So from Siberia to the topmost level of being a tennis player, she remained what? Tennis has touched the hearts of, for the youngster herself, there appears to be no room for sentiment. Though she achieved so much, she never became over emotional. Okay, otherwise people become over sentimental, like people start crying. So otherwise she always remained detached. Okay, she remained like not over emotional. Because when you become over emotional, it means that you become over excited. And when you become over excited about your achievements, then your downfall also starts. Okay. What does it mean that women's tennis has touched the hearts of tennis fans? She was able to impress many tennis players. Okay. She had many fans. They were all impressed by her game. The straight looks and the answers she gives when asked about her ambition make it amply clear that she considers the sacrifices were worth it. So the straight looks and the answers she gives. So how does she look at others? Straight. She would straightway look into the eyes of others, and her answers would be very, very confident. Yes. And the answers she gives when asked about her ambition make it very clear, amply clear, that she considers the sacrifices worth it. So she was, through her talk, it is very clear that the sacrifices she made in her life, they were worth of the achievements she got. Means she got the prize or the award of her sacrifices. The point is the way she looks at others confidently. The way her answers are so crystal clear, that simply shows that she knows that her sacrifices were worth of it, that the sacrifices got valued. When you sacrifice something, you say, what did I get? But what did she get? Success. She got the value of her sacrifices. And it is clear from the way she talks and looks. Okay, her confidence shows it. So what is important? Number one, you sacrifice your comfort zone. You sacrifice your bad habits. You sacrifice your bad habits. The day you will sacrifice your bad habits, later on you will become successful, and you will be very happy to realize that you did something very right then. So that gives confidence. After this, the change of seat will be out of the class. Then no power of the world will let you enter the class. Once I'll send you out, don't expect I'll let you come inside. Be very careful about it. Is that clear to all? Clear? Okay. I'm very, very competitive. I'm very, very competitive. I work hard at what I do. It's my job. This is her mantra for success. It's a very, very important line. You can also have this line as your mantra of life. So what she always says that I am very, very competitive. Like I believe in competition. And the person who believes in competition doesn't let herself or himself become careless at even one point. Because that person knows that the moment the moment he'll become careless, then the other one will have the time to go above him or her. Then there would be 100 people will be waiting for a minute to overcome you. When you're running in a race of competition, then the moment you slack back, thousands of people might be waiting for that 1 second to go ahead of you. So the people, those who believe in competition, those who are in the competition, for them, there is no scope for laziness. There is no scope for carelessness. There is no scope for distraction. Okay, they do not, they don't even, go for 1 second of distraction, maybe of one gossip. Is that clear? So whenever you are in competition, the very first thing you have to sacrifice is gossiping. The very first thing. And in your own class, you can see, because we have to see the examples which are very near us. Right now, for you people, your success is like where you stand in the class. If out of 48, your number is 1, 2, 3, or 4, or 5, it means that you are sacrificing something. And those who are at 48th number, 49th number, or 40th number, otherwise people say there is nothing in number game. Then what are you doing here? What are you doing here? If you don't believe in marks, if you don't believe in caliber, if you don't believe in potential, go out and sell vegetables. Go and do something. Adopt any vocation. There are so many things you people can do. You can earn your livelihood. Then why are you wasting your time today? You are studying because this study you think will help you later on. But if you think you are just passing your time here, then there are so many other ways to pass time. Okay, if you have to just gossip, then go and have a place where you can sit and gossip. Go out. But the people who believe in competition, for them, there is not even a single moment, not even a single second to waste. They cannot get distracted. Right? Distractions are for the failures, losers. Yes. I don't mean that the people, those who are distracted today, they will not do anything. You never know. You never know when will you wake up. You never know. We know examples from history. There are many examples of children, those who woke up late, but they became greater than many other people, those who were successful already. That is also there. But why to be always late? Okay. So she says that I'm very, very competitive. I work hard at what I do. It's my job. So those people who are competitive, they never become careless. They always keep working hard. So though Maria Sharapova speaks with a pronounced American accent, she proudly parades her Russian nationality. So to which country did she belong? Russia. But her accent is American because she has been there when she grew up. Clearing all doubts, she says, I'm Russian. It's true that the US is a big part of my life, but I have Russian citizenship. My blood is totally Russian, and I play the Olympics for Russia if they want me. So you never forget your own country. You never forget your blood. You never forget your own culture. You never forget your own roots. Like any number of teenage sensations, Maria Sharapova lists fashion, singing, and dancing as her hobbies. So because she's a teenager, like any other teenager, her favorite things are being fashionable, singing, and dancing as her hobbies. She loves reading the novels of Arthur Conan Doyle. Her fondness for sophisticated evening gowns appears at odds with her love for pancakes with chocolates, spread, and fizzy drinks. Fizzy orange drinks. So why is her wearing of the gowns and eating pancakes and all? Why is it at odds? She says, let us read this line again. She says that she is very fond of, number one, fashion, dancing and singing. Then she is also very fond of wearing the, gowns. And at the same time, she is very fond of eating pancakes with all fizzy drinks and chocolate spread cakes and all. So what is, why does she say that her wearing of gowns and eating chocolates, they are, these two hobbies are at odds? Yes, who will tell? Raise hand. So what then? What if she is fond of being fashionable, if she is fond of the dresses like gowns and all, then why is it at odds with her fondness for cakes and all? No, fashion is hobby, yes. But why is it at odd with her eating? Yes, very good. Very good. So when you go for chocolates and pancakes and all these things, then there is always a chance that you will gain. You'll put on weight. So she is number one on one side. She is very fond of being fashionable. She likes to wear the gowns, and those who wear gowns, they are very, very, you know, careful that they are in good form. So, but she is very fond of pancakes also. So the point is that though her habit of her being foodie doesn't, you know, cross her limit of wearing whatever she wants, because she can work out also. She's a hard worker. She's a player. So she can manage both of the things at the same time. Her eating too much doesn't affect her because she does work out. Because she's a player, she has to. So the people, those who are hard workers, they are able to manage everything. Okay, lazy people only cut out on one or the other thing. But the people, those who are hardworking, they eat also and work out also. Yeah, lazy people keep on sleeping always. Okay, anyways. So Maria cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. So Mary cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. So meaning is given. Pigeonholed or categorized means you cannot label her. You cannot give her one tag only. Her talent, unwavering desire to succeed and readiness to sacrifice have lifted her to the top of the world. Few would grudge her the riches she is now reaping. So Maria cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. You cannot just tag her as just a tennis player or as just being a fashionable woman, as just being a foodie, as just being a hardworking girl. She has got so many qualities which we can talk about. Her talent, unwavering desire to succeed. What is unwavering desire to succeed? She has no doubt. Unwavering desire to succeed, very confident about success. And readiness to sacrifice, and she's always ready to sacrifice. So the qualities of being talented, the quality of being a very passionate person for success, and the quality of being a person who is always ready to sacrifice. They have lifted her to the top of the world. If somebody asks you, like, what are the three things about Mary which made her successful, what will you say? What will you say? Jaskaran? Three things about Mary Sharapova which made her successful. Yes? Hirde? Three things about Maria Sharapova. Yes, the book is also with you. You can take the help from book. Yes. What were the three qualities which made her successful? Take the answer from paragraph number 10.
the most important thing is to become number one in the world. That's the dream.
Okay, dream word he used. It's okay that she was the one who had the dream to become number one. Her, what is dream? Passion. Okay, her passion made her become successful. Good answer. Sit down. Okay, number two. Number two. Hard work. Number three, Jaskaran. Talent. Okay. Okay, number four. Sacrifice. Very good. Anyone else? Unwavering desire is passion only. Anshya? Yeah, competitive spirit. Perseverance. Yes. Determination, perseverance. Motivation. What motivated her? No, I'm asking you, what motivated her? Yes, her dream. Her dream motivated her. Her passion. Money did not motivate her. One thing, children, I would like you people to listen and understand. No one will ever laugh at anyone. Promise? No one will ever laugh at anyone. And yes, you can always help the others. When I ask a question from somebody, you can always help the other. Help your partner or your friend. You can give him a little bit help. Like, see, the answer is there. Okay? Because we are all learning. Is that clear? Our purpose in this class is never to discourage anyone. We all have to fly together. We all have to fly together. It's not that somebody will fly very high and others will keep on looking at him. Okay? So let's all fly together. Okay, let's finish, please. This is what she has to say about her monetary gains from tennis. Look at this, please. So I guess Hirde was also right. See this? Few would grudge her the riches she is now reaping. Few would grudge her the riches she is now reaping. What is grudge? Complain. Okay, or hate. When you complain or when you crib about something, you call it grudge. So few people would complain about the riches now she is reaping. Riches over here is the fruit of her hard work. So the success which she has scaled by now, or whatever she has achieved by this time, no one will ever complain about it. Everybody will appreciate her for the efforts or for the achievements she has got so far. This is what she has to say about her monetary gains from tennis. What are the monetary gains? Financial gains, money-wise. Monetary gains is the financial profit which she has earned over the years. What are monetary gains, Keshav? What is monetary? Monetary is related to money. Okay? So what? Look at the line. That is what she has to say about her monetary gains from the tennis. Of course, money is a motivation. Of course, money is a motivation. Tennis is a business and a sport. But the most important thing is to become number one in the world. That's the dream that kept me going. So of course, what made her become the best? Number one, the lure for money. Of course, she says. Because when you play, then you get money and name and fame also. But yes, the biggest thing was to become number one. And that made her work harder than anyone else. So have a dream. Not only the dream to have something, but also the dream to be number one. So that she has always been telling us that she has the competitive spirit. So only you can be number one only when you have competitive spirit. Okay, when you want to overcome others in this world of competition. Okay, number one, but before we overcome others, before we defeat others, first we have to be better than ourselves. Okay, what you were yesterday, try to be better than that. Okay, if yesterday you were talkative, today try to become a little less talkative. Okay, win over yourself first. Then start comparing yourself with your previous achievements. Okay, if you secured 80% in the first term, then you can go for 84%. Okay, first have your own, first be your own competitor. Then have competition with others. Okay, but the people, what do they do? First people start competition with others without beating one's own negativities. First beat your negative side. Okay, first beat your negative side. Because what do you study in your chapter of physics? Which do you study, light or darkness?
Light.
Because light is life. If there is no sun, no life. And what do you study, heat or cold?
Heat.
Because heat is a source of life. And if you start studying cold, cold is symbolic of death. Okay, heat is life and cold is death. So if we never study, if the scientists never study the negative side of our life, then why should we be negative? Okay, start beating your negative side. Last chance. If you will not become quiet, I'm going to take some action. Okay, so the lesson has finished finally. So go through the questions. And yes, go through the questions and you people will be answering all these questions one by one. And giving you some time. Tomorrow there will be oral test of this chapter's questions. Listen to me. Tomorrow will be oral test of all these questions written at the back of this chapter. What did I say, Japji? Of tomorrow will be an oral test of the text questions of this chapter. Is that clear? Today only prepare the chapter, read the chapter again. Then tomorrow after discussion in the class, you'll be writing the questions in the notebook. And only the questions and only second part. Let me tell you. Only the writing part. Look at the page number 109. Working in pairs, go through the timetable below. Go through the table below that gives you information about the top women tennis players since 1975. When I read, you also read. Working in pairs, go through the table below that gives you information about the top women tennis players since 1975. So what this table is about, Keshav? It's a table about the tennis players from 1975. Okay. Write now what you have to do. Write a short article for your school magazine comparing and contrasting the players in terms of their duration at the top. You'll be writing an article comparing and contrasting these tennis players. Mention some qualities that you think may be responsible for their brief stay.